item, don't we? Kind of a dozen items for sorting out the green infrastructure of Leicester. And most of them actually come down to a bit of partnership working between the local and the national. Let's pick three out that we can achieve for the city straight away. By request, I'm going to start with retrofitting. Retrofitting in houses and public buildings is all about making current stock greener. In many places around the country, and I'll pick Watford out as a classic example, if you pay £49, you can have your walls insulated. If you pay £49, you can have your roof insulated. That's a special deal worked out with one of the regional partners down there. And it's something once upon a time that we did quite a lot of in Leicester. But now with different financial circumstances and a much different political steer from the City Council, that has largely evaporated. You've got to be in a very small category to get any assistance. Now, the one thing about retrofitting that we can achieve in this country is to reduce our overall energy consumption, both by power and by water. And water's a very interesting one, of course, because that's one of the areas we're running out of most rapidly. Retrofitting, of course, also suffers from one terrible and slightly arcane problem. Anything you do to your buildings in a retrofit manner attracts 20% VAT. If you knock it down and start from the ground upwards, you don't pay VAT, which is why you see so many good quality buildings all the way throughout the commercial marketplace levelled and then rebuilt again. It's utter madness. That requires a partnership between our parliamentarians and those of us out in the real world trying to make a difference. Let me look again at the next one down the line. One of my real favourites, ground source heating. If you put a borehole 33 metres down out from below this building, you'll go straight through the clay layer into the igneous granite that's underneath Leicester, and that's a fantastic source of ground source heating. For those of you who don't understand it, and I presume many of you here do, it's effectively like connecting a fridge up in reverse. And as soon as you start that fridge running, you've got all the heating you're going to want in your house. Indeed, we did a demonstration project over in Braunston at the Small Leisure Centre, and we have to keep the windows open all the while because now it's so hot. Calculations might want to be wrong there. But if I have my way, maybe if I get my way, a special planning guidance that we're putting down for the city, and all the commercial sector buildings of a certain value will have to have ground source heating underneath them. It's a simple way forward. It demolishes our carbon and energy consumption, and it's so easily done. Apartment to the right there, and it's fairly obvious, I suppose, talked about buses, and that's probably because I've moaned about buses endlessly. We have in this city a transport fleet that sits idle for much of its working day. It's not the transport fleet that you see Arriva and Citybus charging your fortune to go on. It's the transport fleet that transports kids, that transports special needs people. It's all sorts like that. It's paid for by the community, it's run by certain groups, but largely, most of the time, it's just unavailable to us. I want to see our parliamentarians giving us back the right to run what we all, who used to live here many years ago, I was one of them, called City Transport. City Transport was the transport operation of the city run by the corporation. It made a profit, it actually provided a service all over the city. It's much missed by those of us who lived here all our lives, and we want it back. It's a very simple principle. If you want the city to run in a greener, more efficient way, you provide a transport infrastructure all of the time, not some of the time. The bitter pill that our parliamentarians have to swallow on that one, of course, is that the operators of both Arriva and Stagecoach, I hate Bank City Bus, are deeply involved in the political process of this country and back both the main parties. So you can't really separate out politics from the green issues. So there's three. I could go on for another 20 minutes if you wish.
You have another 40 seconds if you wish to.
That's all right, I'll give you 40 seconds.
Okay, thank you.
That's the question.
Okay, so we've got one question on the floor.
Have we got a question?
Yeah.
I work in Nottingham and I see a very effective public transport system there, and it seems to be very much still in public ownership, so I just can't understand why Nottingham can have a very extensive fleet of buses that seem to be run by the local authority
set up an arm's length company. It's not actually run by Nottingham City, it's run by an arm's length company, in which they have a minor stakeholding or provider with the capital and can't run it directly. It's a very strange animal, but quite Nottingham in many ways because they do some strange things there.
Yeah.
And they're credit sometimes.
It works beautifully.
Yes, I agree with you.